हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, वी विल कंटिन्यू द मर्चेंट ऑफ वेनिस एक्ट 4 सीन 1 पार्ट 7। इन द प्रीवियस वीडियोस वी डिस्कस्ड दैट हाउ पोर्शिया इंटरप्रिटेटेड द बॉन्ड इन एन इनोवेटिव वे। व्हेन पोर्शिया सेड दैट शाइलॉक वाज एंटाइटल्ड टू हिज शेयर अकॉर्डिंग टू द बॉन्ड एज लॉ मस्ट बी रेस्पेक्टेड इन वेनिस, इट सीम्ड टू एवरीवन दैट पोर्शिया वाज सपोर्टिंग शाइलॉक। But then suddenly twists were there. Portia turned the tables on Shylock's determination and suddenly she took holds on Shylock. Now what were the holds? First she told that Shylock had the right to take the penalty of the pound of flesh, but not even a drop of Christian blood should fall on the ground. Then secondly, there was no question when Shylock was asking for the principal amount, then she said that there was no question of getting money from Bassanio as he had refused it in the open court. So this one we discussed that he already refused it in the open court. So Shylock would only have his bond. So students, why Shylock had refused all the offers? If you remember, there were two reasons. Shylock said that it is not for money that he has come in the court. He wants his due or the forfeiture according to the bond. And he gave reasons that first reason was it is his humor, if you remember, means his wish to take a pound of flesh from Antonio's body. Second, he gave the reason was he had taken an oath to heaven and by the holy Sabbath that he would only have his due and nothing else. And Portia also emphasized that Shylock had already asked for justice according to the bond. Graciano, a Daniel, still shall say I, a second Daniel, I thank thee, Jew, for teaching me that word. So, Graciano keeps on taunting Shylock, and at this point in the play, Graciano provides some humor. Shylock, shall I not have barely my principal? Now, Shylock is asking that just let me have my original sum, that is of 3,000 ducats. Portia, thou shalt have nothing but the forfeiture. No, you are not allowed, but only the penalty to be taken at your own risk. Shylock, why then the devil give him good of it? I will stay no longer. Question. Now, here Shylock is still in angry mood. He is cursing Antonio that then by the devil take him, means nothing would come out of it, and he is cursing Antonio that keeping this amount also nothing he will gain good, so devil may take him, and he would not stay in the court to discuss anything longer. Portia, tarei Jew, means wait a while Jew, the law hath yet another hold on you. Now the second twist, another hold means according to the law of Venice, another clutch. Portia is trying to take Shylock in her grip. It is enacted in the laws of Venice, if it be proved against an alien, here alien means stranger, outsider, that by direct or indirect attempts he seek the life of any citizen, here citizen referring to Antonio, the party against the which he doth contrive, means conspired, shall seize one half his goods, the other half comes to the privy coffer of the state, means to the private treasury of the state. Now students, this excerpt of Portia is very very important, please mark it and listen very carefully. So according to Portia, cross dressed as Balthazar, what was another hold? It is that according to the law of Venice, if it is proved that any alien or outsider to the Venetian city tries directly or indirectly to plot against the life of its citizen, then half of the person's property would go to the person against whose life it was plotted, and the other half would go to the private treasury of the state, and the life of the outsider depends on the mercy of the duke. Means totally now Shylock's half property would go to Antonio, other half, remaining half will go to the state treasury, and his life now depends on the decision or the mercy of the duke. Now again, interruption of Graciano, and as we know that Shylock is a revengeful minded person, here at this point Graciano, not to that extent, but Graciano is also trying to take revenge on Shylock for his deeds. So what he said, beg that thou mayst have leave to hang. So Graciano is asking Shylock to take permission to hang yourself. Since your wealth has been forfeited to the state, thou hast not left the value of a cord. Cord means rope. So here the rude comment of Graciano towards Shylock. Graciano tells Shylock to beg that he must be given permission to hang himself. Thyself means himself. Graciano adds that since Shylock would have no money to buy a rope, cord means rope, so he would have to be hanged at the state's charge, means at the expense of the state. Duke, that thou shalt see the difference of our spirit. Now here Duke again, his comments are Jew versus Christian. Now he is asking so to Shylock to differentiate the to see the attitude of the Christians and the Jews. Now Duke is trying to show mercy, as Shylock's life now is dependent on the decision or the mercy of the Duke. So what does the Duke show the kindness towards Shylock? First he said that first of all the pardon was Shylock's life on his own, means I pardon thee life before thou ask it. So he is showing mercy by himself granting the life, means he is not eager to take the life of Shylock. Now second kindness, for half thy wealth, it is Antonio's, the other half comes to the general state, which humbleness may drive out a fine. So what was the second kindness shown by the Duke? He says that instead of seizing or confiscating his property that is belonging to the state treasury, it could be turned into a fine if he requests. So first half of his property that is belonging to Antonio is Antonio's, and the second half which is belonging to the state treasury, so out of kindness it could be turned into a fine, means some meager amount or a meager penalty or fine he could be imposed. But if Shylock requests, Portia, I for the state, not for Antonio. So here Portia makes Shylock very clear that the half which belongs to Antonio, from there no fine will be imposed, but the half of his property which belongs to the state is concerned, from there he would be imposed little amount of fine. Now Shylock is in a gloomy mood, so nay, take my life and all, pardon not that. You may take my house when you do take the prop, that doubt sustain my house, you take my life when you do take the means whereby I live. So here Shylock requested the Duke of Venice to take his life. Why? Because to live without his money and property, which are his only security, which are the only means of his life, they are taking it away. So it's better to be death. Portia, what mercy can you render him, Antonio? This is very important. Antonio's mercy what Antonio is showing towards Shylock is very, very important. See, before Antonio could speak, again Graciano intervened in between, a halter gratis, nothing else for God's sake. Means, just to give him a hope, free of charge, to hang himself, nothing more for the God's sake. Now, Antonio, so please my lord, the duke and all the court, to quit the fine for one half of his goods, I am content, so he will let me have the other half is in use to render it. Now, listen to this excerpt properly. So here, Antonio returns the property to Shylock that the court has granted him on grounds. Now some conditions are there, that on which ground Antonio is going to return the property, the half of the property of Shylock. First, Shylock can use the property till his death. Second, after his death, the property would go to Lorenzo, who has married Shylock's daughter Jessica. Third, Shylock converts to Christianity. Fourth, he signs a deed, means he has to sign a bond to all this effect. So Antonio suggested that the fine to the state may be cancelled, the other half which is granted to him, and he could return the property to Shylock, but certain conditions are there. But those mercies were at very high cost. Why? Because Antonio insisted that in order to be benefited by all this, he shall have to become a Christian, which is very, very painful condition for Shylock. Why? Because there is always a hatred inside Shylock's mind, not only towards Christianity, but towards Antonio the most. Antonio has also asked that Shylock has to record a gift of all his property to Lorenzo and Jessica after his death. So this was the cruelest blow to Shylock. Why? Because he was forced to convert to Christianity, as he hated Christians in general and Antonio in particular. Duke, he shall do this, or else I do recant the pardon that I let pronounced here. So Duke said that he has to do this, he means Shylock has to do this, otherwise the Duke will withdraw the pardon, the mercy or the kindness that he has just granted to him. So students, I hope up to here it's clear. Please go through it, and the small part is left that I shall continue in my next video. Thank you.